Hello and welcome back to KivyTips. In this episode, I'll show you a quite useful piece of code that will allow you to create, for example, text file templates for your code. For this, we'll use app.config, which is just a local alternative for the Kivy.config. First, let's create a basic structure for our application. You can see that we'll use app.buildconfig method. This method requires one additional parameter, config, which is just an instance of the local, or maybe better said, the current application's configuration. To prevent possible errors, we'll make sure that the application's config is properly loaded before writing to the config file, which gives us an option to change values directly in the config file. Our config file will be named according to our app class name, ignoring the possible app ending in the name. Therefore, if you name your class myconfig_app, the config file will be only myconfig.ini. The path of our local config file is available through app.getApplicationConfig. And as the config is just an instance of config parser, it has the same options like the global kivy.config, namely read, set, set defaults, and many more. Let's create a new section in our local config named myconfig. Give it some values we'll use later when building the widget tree. Here, we build a bunch of buttons with the values fetched from the text values config. Exactly this is what you will see if there is something wrong with the value from the config, yet everything in the code looks correct. To see what really happens, we would need to open the config file. Each value, no matter what type, will be stored as a string, and when we want to get the value, it will be fetched from the file exactly like that, like a string. There are some options for what to do now. You might think about creating a regular expression. Although the expression might be useful, it's not efficient in this particular case, and it would just look bad. Another idea you might have is stripping the edge brackets, however, then we will end up with the quotes and commas. So we are still not quite there. There's the function from AST or abstract syntax trees. That it looks nicer. Let's try something more complicated, such as switching the widgets classes from the config file. So, we have the string values from config. What now? Each of the valid imports is added to the global dictionary of the current module/file, and we can access it with the globals function. If it's a dictionary, we can access the real thing, in our case the classes, with the string value we pulled from the config file. Everything seems to work, so let's assume it fetched the classes correctly. Let's find and open the config file. If you don't know where to find it, just print the value of app.getApplicationConfig. Let's switch our button class to label. Nice, isn't it? What about spinner? Now it gets a little bit trickier. Remember the pulling of the class from the global dictionary? The import has to be done before the class pulling. Otherwise, it'll be just a key error. So, import it and run. Changing the layout, on the other hand, isn't that straightforward, especially if we would switch from box layout to, let's say, float layout, if the child widgets don't have their positions set. Now let's look at the very important difference between the application config and the global Kivy config with setting one of the window properties. The global config has to be on the top before Kivy imports. The application config has to be set before the application is running in the .config. What happens if we try to change the window property from our local config? Let's see. Python will tell you that those are completely different instances, which might give you a hint that the global and local configs are separated. Anyway, let's look what will happen if we try to change it. Before that, make sure you remove the application's config file, otherwise it will be only loaded and our new value won't be written to the file. Well, that's all for now. Thanks for watching.